All right, number 3. All right, multiplying imaginary binomials here. We want to go ahead and simplify this and see what it comes out to. So who knows how to start this problem? Where can we begin? Yeah?
When am I ever going to use this in real life?
When are you going to use this in real life?
It's imaginary numbers.
This imaginary number stuff? When are you going to use this in your real life? That's a great question. Can you wait about 30 seconds? And I'll tell you. Is that okay? About 30 seconds in your real life? Okay. Well, we know to solve this problem, we start by, we can do our double distribution property and multiply it out, and we can go ahead and combine like terms, and we want to think about I squared as -1, is all following, yeah, that's good, and in the end, we can simplify it down, so we get the answer. All right, so real life, huh? All right, class, I want you to put your papers away, all right, books away, just take a pencil out. We got a pop quiz, 1,000,000 points, 1,000,000 points, all right? For the entire semester, if you can solve this problem, is this real life enough for you? Yeah, is this good? All right, go ahead. You got 30 seconds to solve this problem right now. Ready, set, go. All right. So our first soapbox. So I don't know about you, but when I think about in my experience, who asked this question and why do they ask it? It's interesting to me that usually when students ask the question, they don't really care about the answer. I mean, if you think about it. If they're asking about imaginary numbers, they don't really care about when they're going to use imaginary numbers in their real life. There's usually a different motivation behind why they ask that question. Often, it comes from frustration in mathematics. I mean, I have the same students who will ask that question, but the next unit, in my mind, that's totally less relevant, but they get it and they're having some success, well, they don't ask the question anymore because they're feeling some math confidence, they're feeling okay, they get it. Frustration can be a big yield to why students ask that question when it comes out. They're just frustrated. They're tired of not feeling like they get it. They're tired of feeling dumb, tired of feeling just that this is beneath them. Also, math is hard. Math takes work, right? And so again, it's a little defense mechanism that if I'm going to get this, it's going to take work. And I'm not sure, again, that I don't see an immediate benefit besides maybe my grade of why I should do this, and if I don't care enough about my grade, I don't really care enough to work as hard as it's going to take me to actually learn this stuff and to get that. So it's interesting just to think about that when students bring it up and why they ask it. I think again it goes back to that students want to feel, and don't get me wrong, I do think we should try and give as many real life applications and contexts as possible, but I think students as a whole are still looking for something else from mathematics as well. What else am I going to take away from this class? Because I'm going to forget imaginary numbers, you know, a few weeks from now. So what else am I taking away right now? And so I just think about who asked that and why. And there may be some who really want to know, and if we have good answers for real life applications, all the better. But again, what else can we answer with these questions?